fasting, cultivation, distribution, all of these various issues, whatever we call now, everything is included here. So you can note down. One is food. What is food? And what is feast? And what is fasting? What is offering? What is cultivation? What is distribution? What is nutrition? What is diet? What is vegetarianism? Everything will be the English subtopics covered inside. So I want to give a glimpse of all of these various things without going much deeper. Number one, first exercise what we have to learn is not to produce more food or eat more food. What is fasting and how to take limited food? In English we used to call it as abstemious habit. First is fasting, second is being abstemious. Everywhere they are bothering about only one side. Produce more food, eat more food, eat this, that, eat every hour. Eat in your house and also hotel. On the way there will be a shop in the street, you eat there also. Is this the way of developing food security? That is total food insecurity, food alarm. Anna samhara. So we have to understand these things. Shastra says about four things. Dvesha, Nasha, Lesha and Dusha. What is Dvesha? So many people, they cannot eat because they don't have appetite and digestion. So many people, what are the curses of the world? First is Dvesha. So many people, they cannot eat. That is the problem. Dvesha. Nasha, lack of food grains are wasted. Dusha, so many people are tirelessly eating throughout the day without having any other work. That is Anna Bhusha. Anna Lesha is few portions of the world, they don't have food at all, or they have few food. So that results in hunger strike as well as malnutrition. So there is Anna Dvesha, there is Anna Lesha, Anna Bhusha, and Anna Nasha. It is not only rhythmic but also systemic. Or more, becoming more catchy, we used to say in a rhythmic style, but still, it is something very much well connected and well organized, systematically understood. So somebody told, one person who eats once a day, what is his name?
Yogi.
Okay. Eats twice?
Bhogi.
Eats twice?
Rogi.
Eats four times?
Rogi.
So, it is not only a stipulation, it is the ability of a person. Yogi should eat once a day. Only once a day means, it does not mean that you should eat only once a day and you should suffer and struggle for the whole day. Yogi should eat only once a day means, yogi is the person who has such a physical stamina which can effectively, tirelessly function with one time of food properly without destroying the inner mechanism. It shows the ability of a person. It does not show the, because it is coercive practice of a person, it is not shown there. Follow that. So, Anna must be taken like that. So, limited eating and fasting. Fasting should give you energy. If fasting that absorbs your energy and makes you tiresome, your fasting is wrong. Fasting is acceptance of inner energy, whereby you don't require outer energy and a voluntary or what we call a deliberate system of avoidance of external food and totally torturing one's own self, it is not fasting. So fasting can be done provided a person can get the inner energy by which he does not feel the absence of any outer support by food ingredients. That is the greatness of fasting. And number two, we must distribute food to all. Sajiva, pratijiva, havihi, nivedana. These are the distributions. And sajiva means to our own people. That is guests to our acharyas, worshipable people, relatives, friends, everybody, our own family members, we used to do that. And pratijiva is, we used to feed also in Panchamahayajna. We used to feed also crows, we used to feed ants, we used to feed innumerable things which is not there in other practices. So we used to feed that. That is known as pratijiva. These are all the methods by which our consumption becomes less. That means with a small quantity of food, we can do 10 times more the work which we are doing now, which we are refusing to do now, which we are incapable of doing now. Number one. Number two, food productivity and security is also induced. So, for inducing food productivity and security, not only cultivation is the method, fasting is a good method, contentment is a good method, distributing food to others is a method. So, this is the angle of perception of our own food technology. So Havihi is given in rituals and Nivedana is daily offered, whatever we eat. We have to offer to God and eat. Offer it in the puja room, offer it in the dining table. Christians, they used to recite thanks for the bread given by God. We can do it with mantras, with more bhava, we have to do that. Third thing, our physical constitution has been degraded. We are having two problems. One is Shakti Skalana, second is Maladikya. According to our physical constitution, the excretion or the portion excrete should be lesser. It is more than the food now. So that proves that Shakti Skalana, the energy ingredients are not digestible by the bodily enzymes by which they come out. So this type of thing put as manure is more powerful or more nutrient than that of the real food which we are eating, because most of the energy enzymes that are there in food, that is lost by soil erosion. Second thing, they are lost by fertilizers. Third thing, they are lost by overcooking. Fourth thing, they are lost by physical incompatibility. Everything is lost, what we are eating. So that is why I always used to thank God, oh God, there is nothing in whatever you eat, but still I am capable of doing something because you are inside me. If you look scientifically, not spiritually, you can understand that there is some other force working with us, without which naturally nobody can behave like this. Four type of erosion: soil erosion, erosion made by fertilizers, by overcooking like spicy oily cookings, etc. And fourth thing, untimely eating and our inbuilt constitutional deficit that has made food nothing but. There is no difference between food and cow dung. There is only one difference, but that cow dung is very useful. This is the status of food now. So this is our physical constitution. Kindly note down. These things are not humorous. One is Maladhikya, second is Shakti Skalana. Physically, our body is not in a position to adapt the nutritious ingredients and to supply to all parts of the body. It is doing little bit, but not to the level that it is expected to do. So that is that problem. And I want to say one more thing. Sattvika, Rajasa and Tamasa I have already told. In vegetarianism, whatever you call as something vegetarian, it means that most of the food elements are there in the form of vegetables or vegetarian cycle or vegetarian family. That does not mean that all vegetables can be consumed. That is not like that. So even in the case of milk, which is an organic byproduct, it is not a product, it is a byproduct, we are getting a lot of benefits. Shastra says that it has sattva guna inside. And even things like drumstick, potato, onion and garlic, they are from the vegetarian family, but that is prohibited. So if you consider the external or the peripheral surface, that it is beef, it is pork, it is meat, it is flesh, etc., then vegetarian and non-vegetarian is different. If you functionally consider, then whatever 1 gram of beef can induce tamasic inside, 10 times more can be induced by a drumstick. So you are consuming the same beef quality in a vegetarian shell. Then what is the use of this ahara? So this is not meant for common people who are working. For example, if there is a farmer, he takes pariyushita. He takes the food which has been prepared the 2 days before or yesterday's food. He mixes with curd and he takes with his onion and he works. By his hectic work, everything is dissolved and everything is vaporized. You are not like that. For those people, those who are not for any spiritual progress, they are not low intentional, and they are also meant for hard work, that is okay. That is digestible. We cannot do the same thing. So we are having a status, we are having a purpose, we are having a way of life, so we have to adapt our food like that. Now we are not doing like that. So drumstick, onion, this bottle gourd is there. This bottle gourd is very, very, very prohibited in the Shastras. It is very, very clumsy and despicable. It is despicable than anything else.